It means we're trying to keep an old format of show business alive. The Toby Show.
Or 60 years ago, actors came to small towns in the Midwest and set up tents. In all the towns where these shows appeared, it was a time of celebration. Legitimate theater looked down their noses at these shows, but to the people, these actors made the world a better place. Business supported the shows. Farmers and workers left their jobs early. Tent shows displayed a defense of rural values at a time when the U.S. had changed from a farm society to an industrial one. Join us now for the delightful world of Toby, a world that was and is.
By the name of Bates. Come snooping around the farm down here. steal, it's more the truth. But anyway, don't worry. It's gonna have a happy ending, because you see, this here's a Toby show. My name's Toby, and this is one place where nothing bad ever happens to the hero.
Oh, the hero!
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Now, let me introduce some of the folks you're going to be seeing out here tonight. You've already met my musical cousins, Cosmo and Gizmo. Yay! Next, that dirty dog from the big city, Bartholomew.
His lovely female accomplice, Miss Lillian Dumas.
My poor half-wit brother, Zenas. So, let's get this go started with a great big fat
howdy!
All right, let's go away! Thank you, boys. Good job. I really appreciate that. Bye.
We'll holler, Toby!
Hi, Zenas. What you got in the bag?
Milk.
Milk?
Yeah, I got ooey-gooey milk in this here bag.
Don't be dumb, Zenas. You can't carry milk in a bag.
Why not? Cows do.
Yeah.
I don't know me.
Now, Lillian, it's simple. Someday this land is going to be very valuable, and I can practically steal it from these dumb hillbillies. It's a sure thing.
Bates, I am tired of your money-making schemes. I don't want any part of it.
Now, Lillian.
Sorry.
Lillian.
Why is the haunt for the trees again back Lillian. Here?
You're gonna have to... just the man I want to see.
Me?
Yes, you. You know, son, I'd like to buy this farm from you.
No.
And I'm willing to pay you the exorbitant price of 50 cents an acre.
50 cents an acre!
These hillbillies are so stupid. Well, let me just show you how dumb they really are. Say, Toby.
Yeah?
You don't know much about show business now, do you?
I don't know nothing about show business.
I mean, all you really know about are hogs.
I do know about hogs.
Well, tell me, how are your hogs?
Fine. How's your family? See, these are the funny ones. They don't get much better than this. Yuck it up a little bit there, buddy.
Toby, what I meant to say was there's not much distance between you and a fool now, is there?
Oh, I say about a foot between
us. Toby, I didn't come here to be insulted.
Where do you usually go?
Now, see here, Toby. You haven't been telling these good people that I am a jackass now, have you?
Shucks, no, Mr. Bay.
Well, fine.
I can tell that, but look at
about show business.
No, but look.
What are you pointing at? hello, Toby. You wonderful thing, you. Why, it's so nice to see you.
Yeah, it's nice to see you too, Miss.
Now, Lillian, I have important business with this man.
Hold on there, Mr. Bates. I got a little important business of my own to take care of.
Oh?
Over at the outhouse.
Oh.
But I'll just have to use what's in there. How revolting.
Hillbillies! Bah!
Bates! Bates! Hold that, Bates!
Oh, now, Miss Lillian, don't stand out here looking irate. I tell you what, I'll go play the piano and you emote.
Okay.
Oh, I can see it now.
Some of these days, you're gonna miss me, honey. Some of these days, you're gonna be so lonely. You'll miss my hugging. Honey, when I'm away,
Now, you'd better get used to me. I'm in this a lot. Now, I'm out here looking for some raw talent. Raw, unadulterated talent to take to Broadway. I shall endeavor.
Did you say raw talent?
Yes, I'm afraid so.
Well, me and my brother Zenas is about as raw as you can get.
I'll buy that. But, Toby, I don't believe you're of the caliber.
Oh, come on, Mr. Bates. Give us a chance.
Yeah, Mr. Bates, give us a chance.
Yeah.
Chance.
Really? I mean, really. Hi, we've got a great act worked up for you.
That?
Sure, it goes just like this. Hit it, boys.
Well, I really... New girlfriend?
Why, no. What's her name?
Her name is Bureau.
Bureau?
Yeah, Bureau.
Oh, but Bureau's not a girl's name.
Well, then what is a Bureau?
Well, that's the thing about this tall, with short, squatty legs and great big drawers.
Yep, that's Bureau.
Oh, no.
Me, 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 me. You fell down.
Say, didn't I see you in the pet store the other day?
Yes, I went in there to buy me a little pet.
Oh, really? What kind of pet?
A canary.
A canary?
A canary.
Well, what'd you do with him?
I ate him for breakfast.
Oh.
Only because I ran over him earlier with the lawnmower. So I had to eat him for breakfast.
What'd you get?
Shredded tweet.
Oh, look at that hat. Hot dog, I like that. Oh, let me look at that twinkle in your eye. You are a doll. I'll come back to see you after a while. Hi, honey.
Hi. How are you?
You know what? My mama always told me that I could tell an intellectual man by his high forehead, and honey, you got plenty of smarts. Hi. I've never seen so many good-looking guys, and young, too. Oh. Why, golly, it's good to see you again.
Good to see you.
We had fun last night, didn't we?
We did. I'll never forget it.
Yeah, I know. I won't tell if you don't.
I won't.
Oh, I will. We'll do it again some of these days. Toby!
Hey, everybody's buying Kate from St. Louis. Let's give her a big hand. Yippee!
Hi,
it's so good to see you.
Well, good to see you, too.
You know, I heard you coming in up there a while ago, and I heard you saying you was looking for that man for company, right?
Always, always.
Yeah, but what was that other thing you said you was looking for?
Oh, Toby, you know what a tidbit is.
A tidbit?
Yep.
Well, I ain't right sure, but I think I know of a calf that got the tar kicked out of it for doing it once. Not too many farmers over here.
We're going to have to do better than that, Toby.
No kidding. I tell you what, why don't you tell them a joke from St. Louis? You got one?
Oh, yes, of course.
Well, go right ahead.
I always have one. Let's see. Oh, can you tell the difference between me, Uncle Sam, and a rooster?
Let's see. Can I tell the difference between you, Uncle Sam, and a rooster? I don't guess I can.
Well, Uncle Sam says Yankee Doodle Doo.
Yeah.
A rooster says Cock-a-Doodle Doo.
Uh-huh.
And I say any doodle do. I did it, Toby. Got them right in the palm of my hand.
Good. Yeah. Yeah.
Say, Toby.
Mm-hmm.
I hear you got some singers down here.
You know, we have some fine singers here at the Toby Show.
You do?
Yeah, we sure do.
Well, I wonder if they can do the old Cotton Blossom song like we do it in St. Louis.
That's our favorite song!
Really?
Yeah, let me get... Hey, everybody, come on out here. We're going to do the old Cotton Blossom brand case. Come on out here.
Kate!
Lillian! So this is where you ended up. The girls at the house, sure did.
There you go, guys.
Here's a song about a riverboat on the old Mississippi River called the Old Cotton Blossom. Hit it, boys.
sound like a gas leak. Hand me that, my good man.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes. Lillian, come out here quickly. What? I've something I want to show you. Lillian, do you know what that is?
Well, it looks
like... Oh, Bates, you're not going to dye your hair again.
Absolutely not. Oh, good. Lillian, that is oil.
Oh, well, that may be oil, but where did you get it?
Well, there was one particular place on the farm that Toby told me not to go, so naturally I knew there was something there he didn't want me to see. The next morning I got up and went down there. Sure enough, there it was, lying all over the ground. It was magnificent.
Oh, I don't know, Bates. Something sounds fishy here. You may be smart, but I think that hillbilly's on to you. Besides, if he's got oil...
That hillbilly could... Lillian! Oh, women. They simply don't understand big business.
Or baseball.
What I need is some real help. I need the help of someone so dumb, someone so stupid, someone with the brains of an ice cube.
Oh, doggone, doggone, oh, doggone.
Zenas.
Oh, doggone.
What's the matter?
Well, my dog's gone. And besides that, my ma, she's real mad at me. All she does all day is gripe, gripe, gripe.
I know just what you mean. My mother's the same way. The least little thing sets her off.
Well, you're lucky. Your ma has to be set off. Mine's a self-starter.
Say, Zenas, how would you like to earn this?
Who do I have to kill? What do I got to do, Mr. Bates?
What do I got to do?
Go ahead. Make my day.
I have a little job for you.
A little job?
Just a little job.
I don't know, Mr. Bates. I used to have a little job.
Oh, really? What kind of job?
I worked in a donut factory.
Well, what happened?
That went in a hole. But then I worked in a brassiere factory.
Well, what happened there?
Oh, that fell flat. But then I had another job.
Oh, really? Dare I ask, what kind of job was that?
Well, believe it or not, I used to be a pilot.
Pilot? It.
Sorry, sir, we lost your luggage.
Zenas, you mean to tell me that you were a pilot?
Yes, a pilot!
Wait a minute. We just recruited. And you? What's that? That's all, Zenas. That's ridiculous. Gentlemen, please. Shut up! No, no!
Oh, God, I don't know what you're doing.
What did you say? Zenas, what I really want to know is, what did you do as a pilot?
Huh?
What did you do as a pilot?
Well, I used to pilot here and pilot there. Pilot over here.
You'll have to excuse me just for a couple of minutes here. I hope you don't mind, but we had a small problem backstage. We busted this chair, and we used this chair in the second act, and I want to make sure that it's good and safe, so I figured I'd just come out here and fix it right here on stage, and we wouldn't take up any time, see? So I figured we could just talk, or maybe we could even choose up teams and have ourselves a good old-fashioned...
What's wrong, Toby?
I forgot my nails.
Oh.
Yeah, so I gotta run back down to the shed here and pick up some nails. So y'all stay right here, okay?
Okay.
Okay. I'll be right back.
Okay.
Okay. I'm on my way going so I can come back. Okay.
Okay.
I'm going.
Bye.
Bye. I can't leave this junk out here. You see what? Let me explain something to you. See, we got this neighbor fella around here, kind of hangs around the theater a lot. His name's Mr. Posey. Real sweet old guy, don't get me wrong, but let's put it this way. He's about half bubble off center, you know what I mean? And his main problem is he likes to mess with other people's stuff, and I don't want him messing with his saw because I'm afraid he'll hurt himself. So if he comes up here and starts messing with this junk, you all just holler no at him, okay?
Okay.
Great. I'll be back. Bye. See you. I'm... Applause there. I appreciate it. Well, I feel a lot better now, don't you, boys?
Feel great, Toby.
Yeah, it was kind of tense around here earlier. You see, Mr. Bates and Zenas were down here behind the cabin tonight. They was playing mumbly peg before the show, and, well, they got in a little disagreement, and push come to shove. Before you know it, Mr. Bates is calling my brother Zenas names. He says, "You're dumb, you're stupid, you're brainless." Well, I'm here to tell you it ain't so. I'm standing up for my little brother here. You see, actually, Zenas is pretty sharp. He's real good with his hands. He's, mechanically inclined, don't you know? In fact, he's got himself a workshop over here in the basement of the outhouse. And Anyway, that's where he does all of his tinkering. And,
must be a city crowd.
Well, anyway, he's been working on his latest project down in the workshop. We're real excited about it. It's kind of a mother's helper, a chore saver, a tool of tomorrow. We're real excited about it. It's kind of a robot, more of a mechanical man because it looks just like a real guy. It does. I'll get it out here and show it to you. You all stay right here and let's see. Mr. Bates, I was wondering if maybe you could help me with this thing here.
Very well, Toby.
Thank you. Appreciate it. What would you do? Okay, now let's bring it out here like this.
Toby, how come I get the heavy end?
Because you're the heavy.
I knew you'd use anything.
Now, let me see. Gee, thanks, Mr. Bates.
Very
I sure
well.
Appreciate
that's
it.
Well. I'm leaving, Toby.
Thanks a lot.
Uh-huh.
Let's see here. Get this all fixed up here for you. Hold me. Ta-da! Well, I'm sorry Zenas couldn't be out here himself. He's doing chores now. He's down milking the chickens, so that could take a little bit of time, but... Anyway, I thought I'd just go ahead and get it fired up here for you folks, but there's a button here that turns him on someplace, but I'm not sure where it's... I've got a little help here. Lady, you want to come up here and see if you can't turn him on? Hey, I know. Mr. Posey's been helping him. Let me get Mr. Posey. Mr. Posey! Howdy. You seen this thing before? Would you get it going for me? Thanks. Come on over here and get it fired up. I'm going to go down and help Zenas with his chores so he can come out and see the rest of the show. Go ahead, and I'll be... Zenas, you put them pigs down!
Time. I have a plan.
No, not this time. I did it last time and no more times.
Now, Lily...
Oh, shut up!
Yeah. Lillian!
That's my favorite part of the show. Restrain yourself. Now, what we got in store for you folks right now is kind of a parable. Anybody here know what a parable is?
Oh, Toby, I know.
Great. Tell these folks what parables are.
It's two bulls out in the fields. He wrote it. And we paid you for it.
No, you see, a parable is kind of a story with a moral to it. Yes. And we'd like to do our favorite parable for you folks right now in the form of a song, The Preacher and the Bear.
Well, Preacher, he went out walking, was on a Sunday morn. Of course, it's against his religion that he took his gun along. Well, he shot himself some mighty fine quail and one little mostly hair. But on his way returning, tree. Well, there stood up and he rolled his eyes and he shook his ugly head. The tree tree looked up to the sky and these are the words he said.
Oh Lord, you deliver Daniel from life.
Roar, roar.
You the donut from the belly of the whale's head. The Hebrew children by turns up to the dirty
man. Money!
Well, a bear began to climb that tree and that made the preacher sore.
Yeah.
Now, Lord, it may not sound like much.
It ain't.
From where you sit up there. But the hardest job I've ever done. One baptizing that man.
Oh, yeah. The hardest job he'd ever done was baptizing that man. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. I appreciate that generous applause.
Toby, that song has redeemed me.
I doubt it.
But I'm willing to sweeten the ante.
No.
I'm willing to offer you the incredible one time and one time only price of 75 cents an acre.
Boom. 75 cents an acre?
That's right.
Oh, no. I'll take it.
No.
No. No. Hold out, Toby.
Take it!
No.
I don't know, Mr. Bates. I just can't give you an answer right now.
Well, why not?
Because first act's over. Well, if you all enjoy the first act... Great! Because you ain't seen nothing yet. We're all going to be out here in a couple minutes in the second part of our show. We're going to have more singing, more dancing, more visits for Mr. Posey, and a lot more brand new... old jokes. So, in the meantime, head on up the old concession stand. We got cold drinks and we got some snow cones and popcorn. And I'll tell you what, we'll be right back. Don't go away!
Why is it thumbs up for you, Shad?
Oh, thumbs up means we're trying to keep an old format of show business alive. The Toby Show. And that's not too difficult to do, especially when you have talented young people around you and intelligent ones. You know, everybody remembers, especially men my mother's age here, when we used to try to sneak into the old Toby shows and Stalker shows and so forth by raising the fly tent top, you know, or helping to set the seats during the day so we get passes to go to the show that night. A lot of fun, wasn't it?
Yes.
The guy caught it wasn't, though.
No.
Well, the Toby Show is an old, old-time show, and all we're doing is trying to keep it alive.
Well, you're doing a wonderful job.
Thank you.
Shad, you mentioned the Chautauqua shows. Are the Toby shows related to the Chautauqua shows?
Not directly, but the format is somewhat similar, except that they were educational. The Chautauqua shows were educational, and they utilized a lot of local talents, and also had a religious bent to them, moral values. See, they came out of Chautauqua, New York, where the original show started. But the Toby show, for years, it came from the old Repertory theaters, where they used to play in lodge halls up over the stores in the towns and the communities. And then they got such big crowds, they had to go a different way, so they started traveling with tents. But the old Repertory shows were very, very famous, too. And out of that came the Toby show. The old boy, Toby was a universal character. Goes clear back to England, you know, during the times of Shakespeare. Toby, the name Toby, that is. We're the first show in the country, I think, that calls itself a Toby show. Strictly a Toby show. We were rather blatant about that. Maybe we shouldn't have been because we upset a few people on it. But they were better known as repertory theater. The players wanted to be known as repertory players.
But you came out flat-footed and said, this is a Toby show.
This is a Toby show, and that's what it is, good old Toby show.
How are the Toby shows different from other stage presentations?
It was more of a basic story or story of the local area where the shows were performed.
Middle West.
In the Middle West. Now, in Texas or the South, he's a cowboy.
Toby's a cowboy.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. And in the North, he's a lumberman. And, of course, in the Midwest, he's a hillbilly. When it was over in Kansas, Missouri, over in Kansas and those states, he was a farm boy. Up in Iowa and Ohio and like that, he was a farm boy. So that's the character of the Toby show.
Toby, we were different in many different ways in respect to storylines. Our storylines always had a moral issue in hand. And it was generated by the villain, of course, and Toby, who was very naive, but a very moral sort of young fella. And of course, this is where Toby became the lead, pretty much in all Toby shows.
How was the work on the show divided?
Well, they carried very few roustabouts, so-called, or day-to-day laborers to do it. Usually, as I said before, they'd have kids in town set the seats up and so forth. But the players themselves did a great deal of the work in setting the show up. And once the player became identified with the character, why she became or he became much more involved with the actual running of the show. They divided the work up very simply. It was a very democratic process. The players and worked right alongside of the roustabouts or the laborers and helping put up the tent, put up the top and so forth. Some of them would go around town passing out the handbills for the show. And lots of times they'd even have a parade before the show would start. The band would play. And they would march in behind the band to the big top down the main street of the community, very much like the old circus shows were done, the parades.
Once a person was chosen to be an actor of a Toby show and played with them a while, eventually they got such a sense of loyalty as like a family and a loyalty to the show. And some of them had chances to have jobs on Hollywood and Broadway, and they refused to go because they wanted to stay with the Toby show and with their family show. They felt like they belonged.
These players, as I mentioned earlier, would take care of one another and became like a family. And as some of them would leave the show and new young players came in, it wasn't at all unusual for the old-timers, the ones who were staying, to take over, sort of, and help them. They helped one another a great deal. They would teach them the trick of getting that audience into the show with them.
As Toby once said, that Aunt Kate is the one that warms up the audience and makes it so much easier for the rest of us.
That's where the audience gets the chance to participate in the show. You'll always find the storylines very moral in the Toby shows. And we involve the audience a great deal.
How do you do that?
Well, Toby will have some question. He'll ask the audience itself the question. Do you like the show? For instance, one thing he does sometimes. Yeah, we love it. And they feel like they're part of the whole thing. It's a very hard thing to describe or even explain because many of the lines are asides to the audience, and this helps bring them into the show.
I notice when you come down the aisle, Molly, as Aunt Kate, you're kissing people on the head. Now, is that audience interaction?
They participate.
That's participation, isn't it?
Some of them love it. Some of them don't know how to react. So they're the ones that I try to really make react and become part of the audience, because they all come back. When you have made them part of that audience, they come back to the show. 75% of our audiences have our returns, have seen the show over and over and over. And I've watched the ones that I really have had to work on come back the most. As the saying goes, you know, work on. You know what I mean.
I don't know what she means.
You don't? You old rascal.
You're really going to enjoy this.
Right.
Yes, because we have something extra special for you in the form of our very own fugue in the key of C minus B for a musical saw and kazoo featuring Zenas and Mr. Posey. welcome our very own Corn Crib Theater Sympathy Orchestra. Ta-da! This is what we call our audience precipitation number, which means you all got something to do in it. Now, every time that we point at you, we want you all to yell, where?
What?
Nowhere.
Nowhere.
No. You see, where?
I don't know where. I've never been there. I could go there.
Tell you what I'll do. I'll count to three. I'll point at you. And I want you all to yell, where? You got it?
Where you got it?
Where you got it?
Where you got it?
Where you got it?
Where?
Here we go. On three. Ready? One, two, three.
Where?
Nah, I don't know.
You weren't getting any help from the cheap seats, Toby.
Yeah.
So let's try it again.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Yeah.
Everybody.
Yeah.
One, two.
Real mathematicians here tonight,
oh,
I'll
boy.
Tell you.
I'm telling you. That's okay. Let's try it one more time.
One more time.
Everybody.
Everybody.
All together.
All together.
Simultaneously.
All together. Everybody.
Right. On three. One, two, three.
Where?
I don't care where. I want to know when.
Soon.
Now?
Now.
Good.
We're ready to go. We.
Kind of young, kind of wild.
Charlie.
You cut that out. We came out here to play, not play. So nip it. Now, this time we're going to go right into the song. So this time we're going to go right into the music, so I want to hear... Now, are you sassing me? Well, get ready to play. You ready?
Yeah.
Ready?
Yeah.
Ready? Ready?
For sure.
Here we go. On three. How about that three?
Out behind the barn, boys, out behind the barn. I got my education out behind the barn.
When I was only 3 years old, my mom took me aside. She gave me quite a licking. She really tanned my hide.
Where? Out behind the barn, boys, out behind the barn. I got my education out behind the barn.
Later on, when I was 6, my ma got real concerned when I said hello to the preacher with the brand new words I'd learned.
Oh, dirty words, Toby.
Oh, filthy words, Mr. Bates.
Oh, boy.
Words like hecky dern, chucky doodle, and son of a...
Where? Out behind the barn, boys, out behind the barn.
Lillian, she's a pretty little miss. I held her hand, she didn't cry. I stole a little kiss.
Is that all you stole, Toby?
Well, she didn't have no money. I kissed her once, I kissed her twice. She said she didn't care. I kissed her in the hayloft. I kissed her you know where.
Where? Out behind the barn, boys. Out behind the barn. I got my education out behind the barn.
Of work. And it's a life of ease. And I've led a merry chase. I've always done just as I please, and I've been most every place.
Thank you, Tobias.
Don't you cry.
He ain't dead yet.
Are you right, George?
Just see that they bury me.
Where?
Out behind the barn, boys. Out behind the barn.
Just Pinocchio! Pinocchio, Figaro! Figaro, Pinocchio! Gigolo!
And bury me!
Thank you, folks. Now we got a little extra time on our hands. It's time to bring out that animal act we were talking about a while ago. A good friend of mine, Burford Bidwell. He's from Blue Eye, Missouri.
Toby, I hate to interrupt you, but I've taken the liberty of drawing up this short deed.
A deed? What for?
For the old swamp down in the South 40.
Mr. Bates, I told you not to go down there.
Well, that's right.
Well,
you did.
Well, I did. And besides that, I'm getting pretty sick and tired of snooping around my farm all the time. Well, I am. And besides that, Mr. Bates, I'm all embarrassed that old piece of property. Anyhow, it's all grown up with weeds, and there's snakes and lizards and bugs everywhere and all that gooey black stuff all over the ground, whatever it is. I don't know.
Oh, yes, I know, Toby, but you needn't worry about those bugs, you see. I am an entomologist.
You're a what?
An entomologist.
Entomologist.
Ask him. He knows what that is.
Well, either one of you do it around here, and you'll clean it up. I'll tell you that.
No, Toby, that means that I study bugs.
Oh, you study bugs?
Yes, in some circles, I'm known as the father of insect culture.
Is that right?
That's correct.
Got a bunch of your kids flying around these lights. You're an ugly little cuss, but say hello to Dad.
No, Toby. Toby, what I really want to know is why you hillbillies can't seem to make up your minds.
Oh, that's easy.
Oh?
Yeah, that's why we got cleaner minds than you city folk.
Cleaner minds?
Right.
How's that?
We change them more often.
Toby, run center, boy. Toby, glad you could join me.
Why, you falling apart?
No. You see, I need your help.
Oh!
Yes, Miss Lily and I have put together a little skit.
A what?
Skit.
A what?
Skit!
Bless you.
Where is he going?
Oh, he's seen this one before.
How about you?
I like it.
Good. No, we've put together a short play.
Oh, a play?
Yes, and there's a part for you.
No.
This could be your big chance to go to Broadway.
Broadway?
That's correct.
Mr. Bates, I've always wanted to go to Broadway.
Well, I know that.
Oh, boy.
Unfortunately, we're still short one member of the cast.
No.
So if a volunteer would care to step up here from out of the audience, any volunteer would be
a good idea.
Oh, there's a boy in the back with a very good voice.
I want to do it.
Step up here, lad. Let's get a look at you. Step right up here.
I want to do it.
Simple.
Sample.
Because the two of you are very simple.
Yeah.
Huh? Toby, you get to be the villain.
I'm the bad guy.
That's right.
Well, what do I say?
When the scene opens, a lovely young lady will come out.
Right.
She will say, "My, what a beautiful day.
Beautiful day.
I think I will pump some water for my dear old mother."
Mom.
Then you jump out.
Jump right out.
And you say, "Aha, me proud.
haughty beauty.
Really?
Marry me, really? Or be my wife.
Marry me or be my wife?
That's correct.
Boy, you got some snappy dialogue around here. Marry me or be my wife.
Now, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Hold on. Let me see if I got this straight. Now, the girl comes out. The girl comes out, and she says, I'm going to pump some water for my dear old mother, right?
Right.
Then I jump out. And I say, aha, me proud and haughty beauty, marry me or be my wife.
Right again.
I did it.
Yes.
Then what do I do?
Well, then you say, or I shall be forced to choke you.
Or I shall be forced to choke you.
Then you choke her.
Then I choke her.
I'm sure you can do that.
I can do it.
I've got confidence.
Good.
And then there's you.
Oh, I'm in this?
I'm afraid so.
Well, who am I?
You're the hero.
I'm the hero.
You're the good guy.
I get the girl in the end.
No, you end up with the girl.
Oh, I end up with it. Oh, well, what do I say? What's my line?
Tell the truth.
I got a secret.
$20,000
pyramid. Come on now.
Spin that wheel.
Johnny, tell him what he won.
A new car.
A new car. Wait a minute. When you see the villain choking the young lady, you jump out and you say, stop! Touch not one single hair on that fair damsel's head.
Stop! I didn't understand a single word you said.
No, your line is, repeat after me.
Repeat after me.
Stop!
Stop!
Touch
not
one
single
hair
damsel's
head.
How did you do that?
I'll feel it right here.
I'm sure you do.
Now, Toby, when the scene opens, you will be behind that tree.
Right.
Cena, you're behind this rock.
I'm behind the rock.
Let's get started, shall we?
Wait a minute. Let me get this straight now. When the scene opens, he is peeping behind a tree. And I am squatting behind a rock.
No, you're sitting behind the rock.
I'm what?
Sitting.
Ooh.
Now I believe it's time we introduced our lovely leading lady.
Oh, that must be her right there. Hiya, cutie.
No, that's not her. And stop that. That lady wouldn't waste 5 minutes with you.
Well, 5 minutes wouldn't be wasted.
Now stop that. Our leading lady, the lovely Miss Lillian Dumas.
Oh, hubba bubba, what a hunk of blubba.
Miss Dumas, this is your villain.
Oh. Hi, I get to choke you later on. Me and you can have a couple good chokes together.
Yes, sir. Okay, that's great.
And I get to be your
hero.
Oh, well, hello.
You and I end up behind a rock.
Now, Miss Dumas, I believe you know your line.
I think so, yes.
Well, wait a minute. Would you please tell me my line again, because it went in one ear and it came out my nose right here. Oh.
Your line is...
Stop!
Touch not one single hair on that damsel's head.
Stop! The hair on the
places, please. Let's get started.
Okay, I'm behind the tree.
Toby behind the tree.
Right.
Zenas, get behind the rock.
Behind the big rock.
Fine.
Okay. I'm behind the big rock.
Well, get down.
Say what?
I said get down.
Okay.
Way.
Oh.
You're supposed to be hiding.
And they're not supposed to see me.
That's correct.
I better hide then. Here goes.
Hide. Miss Dumas, if you please.
My, what a beautiful day. I think I'll pump some water for my dear old mother.
That's me! And you... Oh.
Doing?
I hit my head on the limb of that tree.
Well, why don't you watch where you're going?
You put it there, Shorty.
Shorty!
Stop! Don't shave her hair! Look at my underwear!
No, no! No! No.
Oh, that one.
No.
I've lost my arms!
No, 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 no!
gave me that sign.
But you got them all wrong.
But I got them all in. What do I say? Tell me again.
Your line is, stop!
Stop!
Touch not one single hair on that fair damsel's head.
Oh, fair damsel's head.
Let's try it again. Toby right behind the tree.
Right.
Same rock.
Zenith behind the rock.
Same height.
Everything. Why?
Because we like you.
Miss Dumas, if you please.
My, what a beautiful day. I think I'll pump some water for my dear old mother.
That's me. Ahem, me proud and haughty beauty, marry me or be my wife.
No, no, a thousand times a no.
And I should be forced to choke thee.
What are you doing?
I'm a fancy choker.
Fancy choker!
Don't you single on her shangle or dangle dingle head. Was that Steven Spielberg? Just give me the line one more time. A little feeling, I think I'll have it.
Feeling?
Yeah, I like some feeling.
You want
please.
Feeling?
Yeah, give me the line.
I'll
feeling.
Give you feeling.
Oh, boy.
Stop! Touch not one single hair on that baby's head!
And don't you forget it! I'll feel right here. I
places, please.
Okay, okay.
Don't be behind the tree.
I'm behind the tree.
Rock. Hi.
And a rock feels no pain.
Miss Dumas, if you please.
Miss Dumas, you're on.
Single damsels have more hair.
Dry up. Now I'm out here one final time. Still looking for some raw talent to take to Broadway.
Oh, no, Mr. Bates, we got a brand new act.
A brand new act.
Yes, sir, it's Socko. It's Buffo.
It's putrid.
Oh, why that?
That, too. And the best part about it is it goes just, put your head up here.
Put your head in there.
Okay, just like this. Hit it, boys.
Not too good. I couldn't find anything to compliment her on.
Well, what about her eyes?
Eyes? When she rolled her eyes at me, I picked them up and I rolled them back.
Well, what about her hair?
Hair? She did have long, curly, long, black, real curly, long, black, curly, long, black hair.
What's wrong with that?
It was coming from her armpits.
What about her legs?
Legs? She was bow-legged.
How bad?
All the way up to her shoulders. But I did find one thing to compliment her on.
What was that?
I looked her right in the face and I said, yuck. You sure don't sweat much for a fat girl.
That was good.
Hey,
terrific. That was marvelous. Wonderful. Stupendous. That was so good. I'm going to take this act to Broadway.
He's
going to
take this act to Broadway.
You're kidding me. Think of the deer then. He's going to take it to Broadway. Imagine me and you on Broadway.
Now, boys, you have everything you need to go to Broadway. Now, we got
everything. We're ready to go.
By that, I mean costumes.
No, we don't have any costumes.
Scripts.
No.
We don't have a script.
Scenery.
Uh-uh.
Music.
We
got one of these. Choreography.
No, wait a minute, Mr. Bates. I thought they were going to furnish all that stuff for us up at the theater.
Furnish?
Yeah.
Oh, no. You must rent or buy all of those things.
Rent or buy?
And they cost lots of money.
Oh, but we don't have any money.
No money? Gee, fellas, that's too bad. No money, no Broadway.
Oh, but Mr. Bates, ain't there something we could do to earn some money?
Oh, well, I don't know, fellas. Should you happen to think of a way to make a little money, why don't you just come see me?
Oh, but Mr. Bates.
Remember, boys, no money, no Broadway. I was emoting. Yeah. Aha! Don't you worry, old Toby, old buddy, old Toby. Toby or not Toby. Don't you worry, old Toby One Kenobi. Don't worry,
huh? Well, why not?
Because.
Because why?
Because I got one of these.
Oh, but Venus, we gotta have more than that to go to Broadway. He don't understand nothing. You heard Mr. Bates. He said we had to have all that money to go to Broadway. Our dreams are shattered. What are we gonna do? I couldn't buy all that junk. I'd just be swamped with bills. Hey, that's it. I'll sell the old swamp to Mr. Bates. Yeah. We'll have all the money we need. We can all go to Broadway. Zena! I get a number of that truck? I think it's a red pickup.
Toby, I see you have a bag there.
Oh, yeah, I got this bag, Mr. Bates.
You know, you took quite a load of money off me for that old swamp.
Boy, you're just not a woofing.
How about giving me a chance to make some of that money back?
Well, I don't know. What'd you have in mind?
Oh, a sporting proposition. Say, $20 that within three guesses I can tell you what you have in that bag.
Oh, but you don't know what I got in here.
Want to bet?
$20?
That's correct.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, why not?
Fine.
Yeah, okay.
Then for my first guess, I will say that you have a tree in that bag.
A tree.
Small tree.
No, I couldn't get a tree in here. That's dumb.
Well, then for my second guess, I will say that you have a piano in that bag.
What a diphthong. How can I get a piano? We only got one. It's sitting right over there.
Well, I'm not doing too well, am I, Toby?
You're doing crummy.
I mean, it looks as though I may lose this bet.
Yeah, it does.
Would you care to double the bet?
Let's triple the bet.
Triple?
Sure.
$60.
Right.
Fine. Then for my third and my final guess, I will say that you have a bottom in that bag.
Oh. Wrong! Ha! I've played this one before.
Posey, what are you doing here? You're not supposed to be out here now. Now, wait a minute. You know, you've been running on and off, in and out, all night long, and you haven't said a single solitary word. Why is that? What? You mean the only reason you haven't said anything is because no one has given you your cue? That's the most ridiculous thing. Wait a minute. You mean you people want to hear this fellow speak?
Yeah!
Oh, you do. Very well, then I will give him his cue. Mr. Posey, why don't you tell them about the shepherd?
Yes. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want, but he maketh me to lie down in green pastures. Oh, he leadeth me beside the still waters, too. He restores my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will feel no fear, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they will comfort me. For thou preparest a table for me in the presence of mine enemies. Oh, thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. That's a long, long time, forever. Yes, forever. Thank you.
There's one.
Wow!
There's another one. Whoa, look at that big one. Hi, Toby.
Oh, hi there, Zenas.
Hey, where'd you get all that money?
Mr. Bates gave it to me.
He just gave it to you?
Well, no, see, exactly. Here's the deal. See, I sold him something.
Oh, no, Toby. What did you sell him?
Well, you know the old swamp down in the South 40?
Oh, you're not talking about the place where
the place where we always take our truck when we drain the oil out of it.
It's worthless. Well, you know what they always say?
What's that?
Let the oily bird get the swamp.
Yeah.
That's a good one.
Absolutely. Oh, hi there, Mr. Bates, Miss Lillian.
Toby.
Howdy.
Say, Toby, I found out how you swindled me on that farm deal, and I've had enough. We're going back to Broadway.
Let's go. Now, wait a minute, Mr. Bates. Hold on there. We didn't try to swindle you.
Oh, no.
We tried not to sell you that old swamp, didn't we?
Yeah.
We got witnesses.
Yeah. And besides that, you can't leave now.
Well, why not?
Because we got all your money. But now we got all this beautiful money, we're going to take our act to Broadway.
Yeah. So what?
Well, so it's a big deal to us. You see,
We're real excited, except we don't know anybody in New York. We'd be lost.
So what?
So you know your way around up there because you live there.
That's correct.
We're going to go with you.
What do you want me to do?
Go pack the bag.
Go pack the bag.
Good. Oh, I can see it now, Mr. Bates. It's going to be great. Why, we'll ride the same trains together. We'll take the same planes together. We'll travel all over the world, entertaining millions. The crown heads of Europe. The bald heads of Arkansas. I can see it now. It's going to be wonderful. Gee, I'm all choked up. There's just one thing.
Get your hands off of me.
He told me to pack the bag.
What's that one thing?
Well, unfortunately, we don't have a grand finale yet.
A grand finale?
Sorry.
What on earth is a grand finale?
Oh, you know what a grand finale is.
Oh?
Yeah, it's the very last song in the show. Sure, it's when the audience looks up at the stage and they all go, whew, finally, hit it, boys.
Vote, vote, vote O'Donnell, Washington at Valley Forge. Freezing cold and up spoke George Head.
Vote O'Donnell, vote O'Donnell now.
Vote O'Donnell, crazy words, crazy tunes, on all that George is Curtis blew up.
Vote O'Donnell, vote O'Donnell now.
On ukulele, daily, he was strong.
I mean a bumbo.
As they throw mandolin, they holler.
Red hot mama.
Crazy words.
You bet. Give yourselves a big hand for being such a great audience.
Absolutely.
Not that hand. You know, you could do us a big favor, too. If you liked our show tonight, we want you to go out and just tell everybody.
Everyone you see.
Everybody.
Tell everybody you know.
But if you didn't like the show,
keep your big mouth shut.